I actually had an interest in the works of Brian Friel. I probably, maybe about 15 years ago. And it's when I moved into my old, my new house, because up the back of my house, it's up on a height, and I can go and I can see, although I never met the Friels, I can see where they lived and I can see where their house was. And I always wondered, you know, what inspiration the man found from that area. And of course he did. He found, you know, obviously he spent a lot of time here, whether it was up in up in North Donegal or in Glenties or around Mulladuff. He spent a lot of time there, and his family still do. But I always wondered, you know, what would inspire somebody. And sort of that got me going. And there was a time in my career, maybe about 2008, 2009, where I had very little work. So I sat down and I started to write. But what I did was I started taking characters out of Friel's works. Now, this only started, I only had about three pieces at the time. And it was things like The Gentle Island, you know, that just the name of it sort of, you know, inspired me to do this. And I got a piece of music together, and then I had another one called Molly Sweeney, which is one of Brian Friel's works. And there's another piece called Ashtrukan, which is the Gaelic for translations. So then I had a conversation with Paul Brown about it, and one thing led to another, and we got the DMEP involved, and Vincent Kennedy got involved, and he got a lot of students involved, and that's where The Night came out of. And I worked on this concept for about 5 or 6 months, and ended up with eight pieces, I think. Yeah, well, I luckily enough, you know, in my career, I've had to the chance to work with fantastic musicians, and people like Donald Shaw, who is a colleague of mine for over 30 years now, and who happens to be the artistic director of Celtic Connections, but with the band, he formed the band Capercaillie, and I joined the band about 4 years after they started up, and I've been there since. Which is, I think, 32 years. But it's mad to be saying those figures. But
and you had, you know, you had Van Morrison's drummer, and you had,
that's right,
Martin,
yeah,
Knopfler's,
yeah,
flute player.
Yeah. Michael McGoldrick, I've been working with Michael for a long time now, as well. And Fraser Fifield on saxophone. And our own Theresa Kavanagh.
Oh, yeah.
And Liam Bradley from up north, up in Inishowen, who has worked with just an incredible amount of really talented musicians. And it came together, and it was only one night, and that's the sad thing about it. It was only the one night, and because it's such a huge project, it would need a lot of backing to put into festivals or to put on gigs alone is a huge ask. So we're there with one night of the music and a video that was made of it, and we'll try and do the best we can with what's on tape.
Thank you. Vincent Kennedy, again, thank you. We're going to start with a piece I wrote for inspired by the play, The Gentle Island. Continue on with a piece called The Faith Healer's Demise. Thank you very much. I'm going to continue on now with another piece called Ballybeg. And it's about the mythical town dreamt up by Brian Friel, a place, a Donegal town, where the sun always shone and the weather was always good. I want a pint of whatever he was drinking. A great concept. We're going to sing you a song now. I I've played with the band for 28 years now, and they never once let me speak on stage. That's why I'm a bit rusty. I watched this documentary on Brian Friel. I think it was made in 2000. And it was a lot about his work, and there was a lot of people speaking, and he spoke a little bit himself. He didn't say too much. It was mostly himself looking out a window or walking on a beach. But I noticed that any time he was looking out the window, he either had a glass of whiskey or a cigar in his hand. And I thought, well, this man cannot go further up in my esteem. And I said, I have to try that. So I was thinking about the play translations and some of the characters, and I wanted to write a love song for the two main characters, Moira and Yolland. And so I decided I would stare out the window with my imaginary cigar and an imaginary glass of whiskey. And it turned out that my imagination was imaginary at the time, because I wasn't getting anywhere after about an hour. And when my dog ran across my view with a burst football in his mouth, followed by two crying children, that was an end to that. But then the penny dropped, and I decided when I thought that, well, I can't put the name Yolland into a Gaelic song, because my parents wouldn't approve, because they were Gaelic speakers. They would never stand for that. So after that, the penny dropped, I started thinking about them and how they may have met up. So I wrote this for my parents, and because my father came from the banks of Lough Erne over to Ranafast a long time ago, and that's where he met my mother. And this is a song about them, and no better person to sing this is Mairéad Ní Mhaonaigh. Curigie Fáilte.
Thank you. Love.